tell us where we are.
Karina, how are you? You're very welcome to Coot Hill. You're here in the middle of Halton's Park, a park which has been recently developed by Coot Hill Area Development Limited. And the park, about 8 years ago, we organised a meeting of both county councils, both Cavan and Monaghan, with a view to developing the park into a better amenity park. And the bridge here, which we put up there to link the two counties of Cavan and Monaghan, has helped greatly. It means now that we can bring people from Cavan all the whole way up to a huge resource in Dartry Forest, as well as Ballymun Forest here as well. And that's really what the idea was, you know, so we could make it more accessible.
Now, I mean, we're talking about the water. What's the river that's going behind us here?
Yeah, we have the Dromore River here on behind me here, and it's going the whole way to Ballybay from here, and it's a Dromore River and lake system. So it's a unique area for fishing, for swimming, canoeing. Tann Outdoor Education Centre use it as a base here for launching canoes, kayaking. We've actually put in barbecues where people can access pipe to natural gas, so we can come in and cook their food. We've also got plug-in places for people with camper vans can get electricity and access them, and absolutely no vandalism. The community are totally involved in
protecting it
and ensuring it, which is unique.
Now, this is a new idea, this outdoor exercise machines. You have a great variety of them here. Talk to us about that aspect of
the
park.
Yeah, we have. We felt that we needed to embrace all the community and bring all the community together, and so we developed the exercise machines. We have a kids' park, children's park already in Coot Hill that we were developed through the Chamber of Commerce previously, and so we decided as Coot Hill Area Development that there was a need for an adult exercise park. So with that, we've encouraged people from, I'll not say the age groups, but we had a guy from 95 years of age here on Saturday at the opening of our sculpture here. He's 95 years of age, and he was the last living member of the family who lived in Halton's house up here behind us, the gatehouse. And people come out here and they exercise the machine at different levels of intensity, but they get a great benefit. We have also tug of war, which is unique as well, where families come together and pull tug of war, maybe the father and mother and a few kids, and they have a bit of a competition.
Absolutely, because we had a go in the machines, and it is good fun. I mean, you can feel yourself exercising, and as you say, pop out for a half an hour, take a walk and go on then.
That's right. As well as that, now from that we've developed a unique area, park run area, which is run here every Saturday morning, and people come from all over Ireland, Brisbane, they come from Australia. They use the park run as a venue to go from, it's done internationally, and 100 runners, up to 100 runners here, and they run 5Ks every Saturday morning.
Now, the big piece de la resistance, I suppose, here at the moment is a sculpture that was launched just last Saturday. Tell us about this.
Yeah, I was very involved in this peace sculpture. It's I'm chairman of the steering group who organised the Building Peace Through the Arts peace sculpture, and it came out of money that was available through the Arts Council of Northern Ireland and the International Fund for Ireland. Mm-hmm. We ended up developing a sculpture based on the linen, based on the theme of weaving the community together, and the sculpture is going back to the linen industry and the whole history of the town back when in the 1800s, where communities came in from all over and settled in Coot Hill, and religions, and you know, everybody just came together and worked together. So we want to reinvite that and build this community together again.